Hello friends, the concept for today is frequency response. So we are going to see today frequency response. Frequency response of a system is a complex function which is plotted with respect to various values of omega. So we have a graph whose x-axis is omega in radians, and the y-axis is a complex quantity. So right now I just write that complex quantity as h e raised to j omega. So frequency response is denoted by h of e raised to j omega, which is plotted with respect to various values of omega. Now omega can take values from 0 to 2 pi, or it can take values from minus pi to pi. So I can have a function drawn from either minus pi to pi or from 0 to 2 pi. So a frequency response, because it is complex, I cannot directly plot a complex number. So I will transform this complex number into a polar representation, which will have its magnitude and phase. So a complex number is represented with a magnitude and a phase. So a magnitude, when plotted with respect to omega, is called as magnitude response, and phase, when plotted with respect to omega, it is called as a phase response. So we can say that a frequency response have actually two responses, or it's a combination of two responses. One is called as a magnitude response, and the second is called as the phase response. So we will have a phase response and a magnitude response, which combine together, it gives us a frequency response. Now there are certain characteristics of a frequency response. If my h of n is real, that means h of n might have some values like minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 4, and so on likewise. That means my given impulse response is real. H of n is nothing but impulse response. So if my impulse response is real, then my magnitude of e raised to j omega, that means the magnitude response, this is nothing but my magnitude response, is symmetrical, and the symmetricity is even. Okay, if my h of n is real, then my magnitude response, or we denoted by two lines, that is modulus of h of e raised to j omega, is symmetrical and the symmetricity is even. And the phase response, which is normally denoted as angle h of e raised to j omega, is also symmetrical, but the symmetricity over here is odd. So if my given h of n is real, then my h of e raised to j omega is symmetrical with this even symmetricity, and phase response is odd symmetrical. What does this mean? With respect to y-axis, the function will be same on or it will replicate itself. For example, if I have a function like this, then across, or if I keep a mirror on y-axis, then negative x-axis and positive x-axis values are the same. This type of symmetricity is called as an even symmetricity. And for odd symmetricity, if I draw a function somewhere like this, that means if I keep a mirror on x-axis, then I have to reflect also, and then there is twice reflection, once with respect to x-axis and again with respect to y-axis. So there are two reflections on the odd symmetry. We say that the symmetricity is about origin. So when the symmetricity is about origin, that time it is an odd symmetricity, and when the symmetricity is about y-axis, it is called as an even symmetricity. So to summarize, we can say that a frequency response is a complex quantity or a complex function of omega, okay, where omega goes from, let us say, minus pi to pi, or we can write it from 0 to 2 pi. That is first. Second, if h of n is real, then magnitude e raised to j omega will be even symmetric, and angle of h of e raised to j omega is odd symmetric. Okay, so these 2 points we have to keep in mind while dealing with a frequency response. Thank you.